Attributes are the fields of the metadata object which can be added in the designer mode. Creating a data object, we see these fields on the item form filled with users' data and stored in the InfoBase. Now we'll check all the attributes we can use in 1C Enterprise with the help of the products catalog as an example. We can open the catalog products editor page by clicking twice on the catalog products itself. We can add new attributes here. Or here. Now, this is the page for adding an attribute in the catalog products editor window. We choose the name for our attribute, which we're going to use in the code. We have some rules for naming almost any metadata object and its attributes. There are three basic rules. Don't start with a number. No special symbols. If there is more than one word in the name, these words are divided into capital letters. The synonym is used in the 1C Enterprise mode for users, first of all. It can be generated automatically, but you also can change it. The commentary is made to let other developers know what to do with this attribute. You also have to choose the attribute's type. And here is our new attribute in the 1C Enterprise mode. So here we choose if our product is weighted or not. So let's talk about these attributes more precisely. We've just added our own attributes, but we can also manage standard attributes or common attributes. Standard attributes are the attributes of the metadata object predefined by the system itself. So let's check it on their specific page. So, ref. Reference is a data type corresponding to a specific metadata object. But when we work with an object, we can read, edit, and write. Reference only gives us to read the data and then use it somewhere else. Code is the unique value for any element that the system uses. Of course, we can change the numeration or adjust the code manually for our purposes. Description is the exact name of the attribute. Owner is a marker for the subordination mechanism. It's used to show the owner of the specific data object, and it's made to filter the information. Parent is the name of the folder where the element is stored. It appears if hierarchy is used. IS folder. It's a Boolean marker to show if this element is a folder. Deletion mark is needed to show that the user decided to delete an element. Now, when a user doesn't have the right to perform a deletion but has such intent, this marker is then used, and the administrator could then perform the deletion. Predefined is a marker to show that the element has a predefined developer value. Predefined data name is the name of the exact element or field in which data is predefined. We can work with these standard attributes just like with any other attribute, but we can't change their names or type. We can place our synonym for these attributes or change some different settings. Here are the properties of the standard attribute code. We can also change some presentation for two primary standard attributes here. There is a specific configuration object named common attributes to be used anywhere you want. These attributes can be added in any metadata object that we can create in our configuration, for example, in our catalogs. We create a common attribute country. So we have chosen country because we can add it as the developer country to the product catalog, or the native country to our contractor catalog. Open the product's catalog and go to the common attributes page. Here we can see all the created common attributes, but we have only one. So we make it active for our catalog. We do the same thing for our contractor's catalog. Now, if we move to the 1C Enterprise mode, we can see all the previously created common attributes automatically added to the form of the corresponding catalog.